Good morning, everybody. Just wanted to welcome you to another day. This is day number 5 of my blog. I am currently at the Cocoa Beach Pier, waiting for today's sunrise. And it looks like it will be a beautiful one today. Here comes our sun. I know, I should have gotten a tripod again. Maybe one of these days. And she's up. Have a good day, everybody. You can see all the sun worshippers here on Cocoa Beach. We're currently at the Cocoa Beach Pier. If any of you watch I Dream of Jeannie, you'll know that Cocoa Beach is where Major Nelson lives. And you can see today, I'm not the only one out here on the beach. There are people on boats watching the sunrise to usher in dawn of a new and exciting day. It is fantastically beautiful out here today. Would be a perfect day to do a model shoot out here, truthfully. That sunrise was just gorgeous today. What you see before you right now is the Cocoa Beach Pier. They have renovated it and trying to make it a major tourist attraction. This is the beach this morning. There are lots of people out here today. And of course, our beautiful sunrise. Beautiful. I just got a really fantastic shot of that surfer dude there sitting there waiting for the sun to rise and to go out there and enjoy the surf. It was just fantastic. And I had asked him if I could take his picture. He didn't mind. After the pictures were shot, I took down his information. Actually, I recorded his information so I can send him the picture. I always try to show people the courtesy of sending them a copy of the picture if you take their pictures. I try to ask people for permission to, you know, take their pictures. And then if I can, I try to send them a copy of the picture in email so that they can see the results of the effort. And just to thank them for their time and for helping me get a really fantastic image. So just a tip for those of you who are doing photography and planning on trying to shoot strangers and whatnot, it doesn't hurt to just go up to them and ask. Most people will be happy to oblige and let you take pictures. And as a courtesy, if you could, you know, get their contact information so you can get them a copy of the picture, that would be really nice. So that's what I try to do, at least. For those of you who are interested in finding this location, we are currently at the Cocoa Beach Pier. It is located approximately a mile or so north of State Road 528, which is the causeway that brings you into Cocoa Beach. So basically, if you're coming from mainland Florida, you cross over on 528, and then that's also known as the beach line. It used to be called the B line, and it heads straight into Orlando. But basically, you come out on 528, which is now the B line or the beach line, and you end up at Cocoa Beach. If you turn right on Cocoa Beach, you end up towards Ron John's and the other tourist attractions down there. But if you want the Cocoa Beach Pier, you turn left. So you're heading north on A1A. And approximately a mile or so up the road, maybe a half mile, maybe 1 mile, you're going to see a sign that says Cocoa Beach Pier. And you can turn, you know, basically to get to the pier. They have metered parking now. It used to be where you just stuck coins in at the meters. Now they got this complicated computer system that I tried to get it to work and it didn't work. I hope they don't fine me. It's $35 fine now to park you without the meter. I tried to pay it and the machine was messing up and not taking, well, it took my money and gave it to somebody else's parking spot. And then when I tried to put in more for my spot, it wouldn't let me reset it and correct it. But anyhow, I'm going to quickly get back to the car because I don't want the van because I don't want to get a ticket here. It's $35. But this is Cocoa Beach Pier. It's got a lot of restaurants here. You can go eat on the end of the pier. And if you can get out here for the sunrise, it is just absolutely, absolutely spectacular. There's a bathroom access there on the pier area. And from time to time, they have like stuff like volleyball tournaments, sometimes concerts on the beach. So this is a really cool place to be if you happen to find yourself in Cocoa Beach. Hi, good morning, everybody. Just wanted to welcome you to Cocoa Beach. This is day 5, I think, of my journey that I've, I guess, restarted. But I'm currently standing on the parking garage rooftop for the Four Points, which is a hotel by Sheraton. It is free parking. We're basically in a parking garage, and I'm at the very top, just to give you a view of this area. Over next to the Sheraton here, north of the Sheraton, is world-famous Ron John Surf Shop. They used to have free parking, which I think that might still be free down there, but it says tow-away zone unless you're, I guess, inside Ron John's. But the parking alongside of the buildings now are all metered. They used to be free, and now they're metered. But I think the ones behind Ron John are still free. And the ones at Sheraton here in the garage, you can see we're at the Four Points by Sheraton, it is still free. So if you come here, just to give you an orientation here, right beyond Ron John's right there, about right next to, like maybe about half block over, is where 528 intersects with A1A. That road down there that you see is A1A. And so if you're coming here from I-95 or Orlando and you come on 528, you would come down till you hit this intersection right here. And if you go straight through, you'll hit the beach area where you can pay for beach parking to access Cocoa Beach. Or you can go up A1A and head towards the Cocoa Beach Pier. Another thing you can do that I actually prefer versus going up A1A is to drive all the way down 528 until you hit this side road. I don't know what it's called here, but there's a second road past A1A, and you turn left, and you go up there for about, I guess, half a mile to 1 mile, and the Cocoa Beach Pier will be on your right-hand side. They have metered parking there now as well. It's using some, you know, the stupid punch-in card things. I tried to use it this morning, and it didn't work. So I parked there to get a nice shot of the Cocoa Beach sunrise. And so if you go there, be aware that there is metered parking. And I did my best. I hope they don't ticket me. I tried to pay, and the thing wouldn't take my money. It was messed up. The buttons wouldn't work. But Ron John's is pretty cool. It's got a lot of cool things inside. We might go look in there a little bit. The problem I have is this camera that I'm using, it's actually a cheapo $10 Android phone, and it doesn't do very well in low light situations. So trying to film inside a building, like even Ron John's and stuff like that, I don't know if it's going to be worth it. I don't think it is, because my past experience when I tried to film at Walmart or at Home Depot, it came out like crap. So maybe I'll just talk about it, and you can see what's inside for yourself. But Ron John's has a lot of cool stuff. It is a major brand. You know, it is world famous. And they basically have beachwear, beach gear, beach toys. And there's a shopping plaza over here. I think most of these places have free internet access. But if they don't, there is a McDonald's that's further up that way, probably about another block or two. And I'm pretty sure McDonald's has Wi-Fi access. So we're walking towards the other view here. I just wanted to show you. It's like a lot of people coming up here. I don't know if they're coming here for pictures or what. But this is the overlook for the Cocoa Beach. Over there beyond where you can see the water is the Atlantic Ocean. And the pier is just up there, just a little ways. Yeah, it looks like those kids that are up here are here to take pictures, because this is a pretty cool photo spot. It may be one of the highest points you have in Cocoa Beach that you can get free access to. So coming up here, you can look up and down the strip. This whole side right here is all touristy. And I think that's going to conclude our visit for Cocoa Beach. There's a lot of parks here, as well as beach access. Most of the beaches have showers. And of course, you got restroom access. You have picnic tables. So it's a pretty good spot worth checking out. You could probably spend a day just exploring Cocoa Beach. There's a lot of touristy things here. If you go up 528, which we might do later today, there's a mall over there. And there's some other parks nearby that area. So it may be worth checking out. I'm gonna go ahead and head out now. My plan today is mostly to get caught up on everything. I need to finish up some videos, upload those videos, and just try to close things out. So I'm kind of waiting for the library, the Cocoa Beach Library, to open, and then I plan on basically using the library today to finish my uploads. Process some pictures. I got some really fabulous shots of the sunrise this morning at the pier, and lucked out and found a surfer dude there, and I think those are going to be like awesome images. But I shot like some silhouettes of the guy sitting there waiting for the sunrise with the pier in the background. It was just fabulous. I took his contact information and plan on sending him a free copy of the photo, but I'll probably post that photo somewhere online, maybe on my The latest click might be it, because even though I have a photography website, I think I may post it on the latest click, just because that's my blog site that's kind of been stagnant. It's just been sort of just sitting there. So I'm going to do maybe an entry and just have photos there where people can come look at the photos and purchase copies if they would like. So I guess that's it for now. I'll talk to you later. If not, I'll see you tomorrow. All right, rather than leave this area and not at least show it off for those of you who may be visiting one day, I thought I'd go ahead and try to film the segments anyways. What you're looking at right now is the Cocoa Beach Surf Company, which is a competing store to Ron John's, believe it or not. And it is located right at the Four Points by Sheridan. It's a tourist hotel, basically. Almost, I don't know if it's a resort, but it's a nice hotel by Sheridan. And that back area there is the parking garage where you saw me filming from earlier. It is free, so you can come in off up A1A here. There's 528 right there, that junction where you see the big red truck coming through. That is 528. So you'd come up there, take a right to head south on A1A, and then within a block you're over here where you can turn in and you can park at the Sheridan, or you can park at Ron John's right behind there in the back. This is Ron John's over here on this side, and they got some cool sculptures and other things to look at here. I think those surfboards right there are actually bike racks. So they've got music out here for you to enjoy. Fake tiki poles made out of cement. And some sculptures. This is actually a major tourist attraction here at Cocoa Beach. So, I mean, even though I'm stuck here, I feel kind of fortunate that I'm in Brevard County. Brevard County is a tourist destination. It's got Cocoa Beach, which has awesome surfing, and you know, it's got Ron John's here. It's got a lot of other little tourist attractions. So even though I haven't officially hit the road, you know, as far as traveling across the country or anything like that, I'll go ahead and try to give a tour of this area that I'm fairly familiar with because I've lived here for a long time. But for today, we're going to explore Cocoa Beach. Here is the entrance for Ron John's. Nice big huge sculpture here of a surfer. And I think there's even Wi-Fi here, so I might upload a couple pictures and stuff to Facebook. This is the front. And the reason I'm filming mostly out here is because I know that if I try to go inside and film, it's going to look like crap. So I don't even think I'm going to try it. The reason it'll look like crap is just because of the low light, and the video will start blurring, and it's just give people a headache kind of watch it. So I'll just show it on the outside here. But there's you could have a little picnic here. So that's giving me an idea here. I might end up coming down here to cook. I bought some bacon this morning, so maybe I'll have bacon and rice out here. But they have dining out here, so. And it looks like this side is parking for Ron John, so this parking here doesn't look metered. Even though on the other side it is metered, this side looks like it's just regular parking for Ron John's. And since they're all open right now, I think I'm going to take advantage of it. I'm going to move my van from Sheridan and bring it over here and park. And then I'm going to make breakfast. So we're going to have breakfast at Ron John's this morning. How awesome is that? All right, I was able to confirm that Ron John's still has free parking here, as you can see. Basically, the parking slot's right next to Ron John's, all along the sides and the back of the building. So when you pull into Ron John's here, you pull right alongside Ron John's and park all down through here, as well as right behind the building. This is all free parking. Otherwise, you're going to be paying, I think it's like they were charging like $2 or $3 per hour. To park at Cocoa Beach now with the new metered parking. You used to be able to just put quarters in for 15 minutes at a time, but now they're charging $2 an hour at least. I'm planning on parking here with Lil Blue today, and I don't know how long I'll stay. I probably won't stay all day because I have to go to the library to do some uploads and some work and try to get into a real routine where I can actually produce some work and try to bring in some income, because that's a major issue right now. But for now, I'm going to stay here and cook up some bacon, which I bought this morning. I actually spent the night over at the Walmart off 528 over there in Cocoa Beach. Off 528, which is right here at this intersection that you see ahead. Just up the road a couple miles is Walmart where I was parked. And I bought some bacon, and I'm planning on having bacon and rice for breakfast this morning. Just thought I'd do a quick, how-to or information as to what's currently going on. I'm for that car to go by here. I'm cooking